That was truly a beautiful moment, and we just want to tell the Lord we love you, Lord, this morning. So welcome to Adam's Basin. Blessings to everyone, and happy Mother's Day. What a happy day it is. And we're happy to just be fellowshipping this morning as the congregation that we are. So if anyone has an announcement to make at this time, then do so. We have the usual here in the back of the bulletin that you can read.
There is the Spencer Port Chicken Barbecue. The poster's on the bulletin board. Oh, I have an announcement. Some of you may not know that there's going to be a retirement party for Pastor Jack. And I sent out an email, but in case you missed it, you need to respond to Sasha Stafford by the 22nd, I think. It's going to be June 4th. And it's at Pineway Ponds in one of the lodges. And it's like 11-ish. 11 to 4. Sorry, my mind's going in different directions. But yeah, so respond to Sasha, and if you don't have her info, send me an email and I'll get it to you.
And you know, it is a privilege for, I've never met him, I don't know him, but he was a pastor, you know, and blessings to him for that journey and for, you know, being a spiritual guide and a pastor for probably many, many years. That is something very beautiful, to really dedicate your life and so many years to the Lord and the service of a congregation. So we will then, if there are no other announcements, we start our praise and worship service. We gather as a family of God, and by bringing in the light of Christ.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
transforming God, you have taken the world's darkness and recreated a world filled with the joy of light and hope.
Come and hear the good news of God's love for all creation.
Restoring God, you have turned defeat into sudden victory and recreated a world filled with the joy of peace and shalom.
Come and hear the good news of God's awesome powers.
Renewing God, we respond to your mighty deeds with songs of praise, worship, and thankful prayers. You alone are God.
Come and hear the good news of God's blessings on us all. Glory and honor, power and dominion belong to God alone. Amen.
And our praise song, Easter People, Raise Your Voices, number 304 in your United Methodist hymnal. Our scripture reading this morning is from 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 13 through 22. Hear these words. Who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear. Do not be frightened. But in your hearts, set apart Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you, to give the reason for the hope that you have. But do this with gentleness and respect, keeping a clear conscience so that those who speak maliciously against you or good behavior in Christ may be ashamed of their slander. It is better, if it is God's will, to suffer for doing good than for doing evil. For Christ died for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit, through whom also he went and preached to the spirits in prison, who disobeyed long ago when God waited patiently in the days of Noah while the ark was being built. In it, only a few people, eight in all, were saved through water. And this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also, not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of a good conscience toward God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at God's right hand, with angels, authorities, and powers in submission to him. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
The word and the message today from the Lord to us, and I want to say from the Lord to us because, you know, when we stand up here and we want to bring a message from God, we prepare ourselves in prayer and in reading the word and meditating. And so it is, and it speaks to me first, and then I share it with you. I really enjoyed 1 Peter chapter 3 and these verses. You know, it's just a reminder of how we have to walk no matter what. I always say, and I say it every time I open my mouth in this, you know, in this type of scenario, that life is very hard. Life is hard. We're not saying that it's not difficult and that we're not human beings. However, you know, the Lord expects a whole lot from us, you know, as Christians and as we have been transformed over the years. So the thing today is fear nothing and let's live for God. And I do want to do two things. I want to read a poem for Mother's Day. And at the end of the message, I do want to give an encouraging word to mothers, grandmothers, and great-grandmothers. I was encouraged by it because I do have three grandchildren that are boys. And, you know, the world seems a little dim right now. Not a little. I forgot to write down here who wrote the poem. I did write it. I think it's someone called Sarah, but at least I'm letting you know. So it takes a mother's love to make a house and a home, a place to be remembered no matter where we roam. It takes a mother's patience to bring a child upright, and her courage and her cheerfulness to make a dark day bright. It takes a mother's thoughtfulness to mend the heart's deep hurts, and her skill and her endurance to mend little socks and shirts. It takes a mother's kindness to forgive us when we err, to sympathize in trouble and to bow her head in prayer. It takes a mother's wisdom to recognize our needs and to give us reassurance by her loving words and her deeds. Absolutely love this. So as I began to write this sermon, I started with a different tone. and different scenario. And as I was writing, I felt in my heart to address mothers at the end of the message today. And I also feel that it's appropriate, you know, since it's Mother's Day, so happy Mother's Day to us all once again. I will start off by stating that the scriptures to share today as a word of God for us today in 1 Peter chapter 3, as I mentioned, Peter speaks to the hearers of that time and that moment. So whoever was listening when he was writing, that's who he was addressing himself to. The Apostle Peter, whom we know really well. His message was about resisting those temptations of responding to those who do us wrong with evil. The theme to this passage is, of this particular one in the Bible, suffering for doing good. And today we will say, fear nothing, and let us continue to live for God. The only way you and I can understand scriptures is if we can relate to it and bring it to our day and time. And the experiences that we ourselves are seeing and of course experiencing in our daily life. Today, many of us have difficulty with resisting when someone has hurt us or has done something awful to us. Even as Christians, you know, we still resist. We're not speaking of those who do not serve the Lord. So we're speaking about Christian people. We struggle with unforgiveness. And when we are not able to apply the scriptures to our walk, our flesh rises quickly and defends itself with attitudes and anger. And I've been there. I'm only speaking of experience. I don't know if you've experienced no sleep at night because of something that has happened. Perhaps a conversation that ended badly. Perhaps we said something we shouldn't have. Or we have wronged someone, or someone has wronged us, and our conscience is dictating us while we're sleeping or attempting to sleep. And our heart is telling us that something is not right. If you can turn off your conscience, you may not be in a good place. This made me laugh, because really, if we're able to turn that off, that's not a good thing. We know that there are people that can easily offend others and live a wicked life and continue life with no repentance at all. But that is not us. The Apostle Peter addresses these situations in a general form. He says, who will want to harm you if all you want to do is good by people? He's asking a question to help us reflect on what he is saying. And we all know that we could be the greatest people in this world and we could still get very hurt. And things can happen to us. He further states in verse 14 that even if we suffer for doing what is right, God will reward us. The expectation is that we do the right thing always. Peter reassures us not to be afraid of these actions and the things that may be threatening to us. In other words, God expects that while we are experiencing difficulties that are harmful, that are hurtful, or are threatening in any way, our attitude, demeanor, and lifestyle show that we are believers and followers in Christ. Something that only transformation does, because it is not easy. As Christians, we must react differently than how the world reacts to difficulty. Examples are people who have issues with colored people, people who resolve everything with violence, whether in words or attitudes and threats, over small things sometimes. Tailgating. Has anybody experienced tailgating? Or we're driving too slow and somebody has road rage. A sports game, we know that parents can become violent. We see all of these things. And there are so many other situations that happen that we experience. And let's take this deeper. When a shooter kills children in schools, kills a family member in a store or at a church, it has happened in our nation. How do we react? And I'm not saying that we should not take steps and apply justice, not at all. I am speaking that in our hurt and pain, we should have the ability as Christians to behave and have Christ-like characteristics. And as you heard our sister reading these verses, and how Christ handled the crisis that, you know, he himself experienced. An example is when we take justice in our own hands. The things we do and say have weight, and our spirit that is connected to God will be speaking to your heart. And that's called the Holy Spirit speaking to our conscience. This is what the apostle is saying, that when we react, we do it as expected, in respect and ensuring that your conscience is well as a Christian. So I hope that you can relate. I know that every one of us goes through some type of, one day we go to sleep and something's really bothering us and we can't sleep. And sometimes we don't know what it is, but it's probably something that has hurt us, or we have hurt someone and we just are not able to sleep. So I just want you to relate it in that manner. In verse 16, Peter says that when all is done, we should be able to rest and have a clear conscience about the things we do and the things that others do to us. A Christian life is not any life. It is a lifestyle that we must be willing to live as Christians. Peter shares in the scriptures as an example the life of Christ, how he suffered at the hands of his own people and those who upheld the law. So how closer can it be to our hearts when our family members hurt us? You know, when a friend that is dear to us, and it happens every day and it happens all the time, when people really offend us and hurt us, how should we react to those things? So that our heart is clean and that our conscience is also clean. It's very attached to the unforgiveness. So when things happen to us, we have to have that heart to forgive. Something that I struggled with years ago. And it taught me quite a lot about forgiveness. The point is that the sufferings are not in vain. God is always working something when we're going through something. Believe that God is working something in us. It's mostly for us than for the person that's offending us. And we must leave that to God, and God will deal with the person. The point is that sufferings are not in vain. God rewards us when we do what is right and have the heart of God turning. When we have the heart of God during difficult times. No, it is not easy. Many days, it's not easy. However, God expects that you and I have the attitudes that glorify him in all we do. So imagine that every time we think of something and we're going to open our mouths, we ask ourselves, is this going to glorify God? Then maybe I shouldn't open my mouth. I do that all the time. It will not be easy for some of us, those of us who have strong personalities and have deep convictions and opinions. But being peacemakers and waiting on God is very important. Allowing our anger and not having self-dominion over our emotions is disastrous. It only opens doors to our enemy so that he can wreak havoc and making our situations worse. Today, I just want you to reflect on that. We all know who the Lord is speaking to. I know that the Lord speaks to me all the time through this, and this is how I'm being transformed, that when I'm going to open my mouth, I have a very strong personality because of life experiences, and it's not an excuse. Strong personalities are good, but sometimes we're too straightforward, and that is also not good at the wrong times. Mm-hmm. So, you know, let us just reflect and intake that. I intake, you know, and I thought about the many instances that I could have said something in a better way, I could have done better, you know, and even with my own enemies, you know, at work, you know, people who the enemy uses to try to, you know, create some situations, I believe that when we're godly people, we just step in and, you know, the glory of God is walking with us and peace comes about. And I'm not sure where the verse is, but the verse says that when we are walking with the Lord and in obedience, even our enemies are at peace with us. And how, you know, wonderful that is, that when someone just does not like you for whatever reason and they've waged a war against you, God will put them at peace with you. And even then, some things will offend us and we will feel hurt. But what we will do is, you know, return with good deeds. And I think that that makes a difference. Amen to that. So today there's a word for mothers and grandmothers and great-grandmothers to continue and pray without ceasing for our adult children and grandchildren. We must continue to declare into their lives and plant seeds of wisdom and of making good choices into our children and grandchildren. There is a promise in what the Apostle Paul stated in verse 13, "Now, who will want to harm you if you are eager to do good?" It sounds simple, but at the same time, at the time of applying the words is where you will see your own spiritual maturity on how we handle the difficult experiences. I will say that I am fearful of what is out there for our grandchildren and our children, who for most of us are adults, our children are adults, but some of us have daughters who are in their 20s, like Brother Russ and Elizabeth. As mothers and grandmothers, I'm anchored in the promises of God and His mercies, always, every day. This is why we must model to our families Christ-like characteristics of knowing how to handle the situations our children will see and our grandchildren will see in us, you know, modeling Christ. And they will, in turn, you know, practice the same things. I will admit that I'm not the best mother or woman to handle difficulty at times when I have been hurt or damaged, but I have learned along the way to improve and make strides in my walk in peace with my neighbor, my family, and my friends. I commend and congratulate every mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother who has walked this path with suffering, sacrifice, and love. We have definitely done all of those things. Do not fear that you have not seen some things you would like to see in your adult children and grandchildren. Wait on the Lord with patience and perseverance. With faith, the kind of faith that declares and calls on what you cannot see, but will come forth in God's timing. I believe that. Amen. Let us bow our heads in prayer. God of mercy and kindness, we thank you. Please continue to encourage us to be like you, Christ, to be like you, Christ. That as we walk this journey, we feel your strength, your voice that tells us what we should do and should not do. Give us a heart and a spirit like yours, O Lord. Bless every mother and grandmother and great-grandmother this day. Strengthen and fortify our prayer and our wisdom that we continue to impart in our families as the givers of life that you have created in each of us. We thank you for the privilege of being mothers and grandmothers. To you be the glory and honor. Amen.
Amen.
So we will proceed now to sing the hymn, Spirit of the Living God, Fall Afresh on Me, on number 393. And you may stand if you wish so. And our blessings to our sister Cindy, who is out in the other church. I'd like to pray different prayers. For some reason, I am using my home laptop instead of the one that I usually, and of course, not everything recorded, but it doesn't matter. So, Heavenly Father, we just thank you. We thank you for all of your provisions. We thank you for everything that you have given us. And with everything that you have given us, we will bless you, we will bless the church, and we will bless each other, Lord, as your congregation. In your name, Jesus, amen. And let us now pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. So let us now take time to share our joys and concerns.
It was a joy to walk the crap walk last week, and our team leader, Cindy Hay, said that our team raised $600 for the crap hunger walk. And it was also a joy to see Priscilla's daughter, to see Pastor Marisi's daughter, Priscilla, there with her husband, and Bash and Gio. They walked too.
Yes, they did tell me they didn't do the 6 mile, but they did 4. Yes, but that doesn't matter. I guess the efforts. Yes. A, E for effort. Yes, but I thought that was a wonderful, a wonderful event. And some things that, we should participate. I love walking, so. Wonderful. I hope that they were able to really have, enough funds that show the support. So, blessings to all of these events and all of these fundraisers. Anyone else?
I'm going to have a little biopsy on this week. I don't think it's going to be anything because I've messed with it for a long, long time and it was really bad once and I got it healed over, but he, plastic surgeon, said he wants to look at it, so.
And we trust the Lord. We trust the Lord. So we've got to keep our Sister Carol in our prayers that the Lord continues to embrace her. And help her and strengthen her body, with the falls too. Continuous prayers. Anyone else want to share? Well, while someone else prepares, I'll be going to without my husband for 7 days to pass their licensing school. It's over there in Owasco. So I'll be leaving tomorrow. I will not be here next Sunday, but you'll have somebody very exciting here. Superintendent Ted, I believe that he's the one that's going to be here. So, yes, I am excited about pastor licensing school, but it's away from my home and my bed, so that's a big hard. And then I have to leave Emily behind too. So, thank God for a messenger. I'll be messaging every single day, right? So, but it is an exciting, it's something very emotional and exciting for me, so I will definitely enjoy it. Anyone else want to share? No? Alrighty, so I will be praying then for our Sister Carol and anyone else who is sick, I'm not really sure. But Heavenly Father, we thank you for the joy that we feel today, that we have been able to just wake up and breathe, Lord. Many people cannot say so. There are many people who are sick. They're bound in bed. They're in hospitals. They're in nursing homes, Lord. So we pray that your strength and your Holy Spirit comforts and embraces. We also pray for our brother Bob. We continuously pray for his health, Lord, and that you can also help him and his part in taking care of his health with his eating habits. But we also pray that your powerful hand, your healing hand is over his body, Lord. And we also pray for our sister Carol, Lord, that you continue, Lord, to comfort her in her home, comfort her in the times that she's feeling low, Lord. I pray over this biopsy that, you know, that it's nothing, Lord, and that you continue to give her health, that she still looks very good, Lord, and you help her, Lord, put safeguards and awareness in her mind about falling, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that you continue to bless her and keep her safe and anyone else that is going through health issues, Lord. And we pray all these things, Lord, in your name, Jesus. What would be our next thing? It would be our song. So if you would like to stand on your feet, number 393, Spirit of, I'm sorry, number 534, Be Still My Soul.
Thank you.
have a wonderful day. Please enjoy each other's company and your family's company. Blessings to you all.